वेलकम टू अवर ज्योग्राफी क्लास. आई होप यू सीन माई लास्ट टू वीडियोज ऑफ टू लेसन्स. द नेम ऑफ फर्स्ट लेसन इज लोकल टाइम एंड स्टैंडर्ड टाइम एंड सेकेंड लेसन इज इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ. आई होप यू कम्प्लीट यूर एक्सरसाइज ऑल्सो फ्रॉम टू लेसन्स. हियर नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट द थर्ड लेसन ऑफ अवर ज्योग्राफी सब्जेक्ट ह्यूमिडिटी एंड क्लाउड्स. कैन यू टेल लुक एट द पिक्चर शोन इन फिगर 3.1. Students, see here on the picture 3.1, discuss the weather condition shown in this picture in the class and write description in the boxes below. You see here three pictures of different types of climate. In first picture, in the picture of in Rajasthan, it's very sunny today. The wind has stopped blowing. I foresee sandstorm. Let's go quickly inside house. Yes, even I feel the same. Come, let's go fast. In second picture, we see the buddy, it is very hot today. Yes, Soham, I am literally soaked because of the sweat. Then in third picture, children, come fast. Wear your sweaters and then play again. Mummy, please wait. Let's play, please. We see the different types of climate in these pictures. Here starting geographical explanation. Generally, we keep talking about the weather condition. We can identify the weather condition through the conversation above. We experience the dampness and dryness in the air throughout the year. The changes occurring in the weather condition in desert areas, coastal areas, mountainous areas is evident from the figure. Rajasthan lies in the region with dry and hot air. You know, student, in Rajasthan, region with dry and hot air, there is hardly any moisture in the air. People wear loose and cotton clothes. The climate of Rajasthan is very hot, so there people wear the loose cotton clothes. Then Kashmir Valley. Here, then third picture is Kashmir Valley lies in the region with cold and dry air. In the valley of Kashmir, the climate is very cold and dry. Moisture is minimal in the air. People cover themselves with the warm cloths. In Kashmir Valley, people wear the warm cloths. In Mumbai, here second picture is in Mumbai, there is hot and humid. In Mumbai, the atmosphere is very hot and humid. Humid is for that they are near the sea coast. There, the proportion of moisture is very high in the air. In addition, in dark clouds cover the sky. This content of moisture in the air increase. Here, student, in Mumbai, the air is very hot and humid climate. There, the proportion of moisture is very high in the air. In addition, in dark clouds cover with in the sky, the content of moisture in the air increases. In the above discussion, the words hot, moist, cool, etc. show the condition of air. These words, which words? Hot, moist, cool, condition show the condition of air. They related to the content of the moisture in the air. Moisture in the air is invisible. You see the moisture of air? No, moisture is in air is invisible. But it is major component of the air which is taken into consideration while discussing the weather of any place. Moisture is important to consideration which in discussing the weather of any place for precipitation to occur in any place, and presence of moisture in the air is very important. Yes, student, in the above discussion, the words hot, moist, cool, etc. show the condition of the air. The word hot, moist, cool show the condition of the air. They relate to the content of the moisture in the air. Moisture is the air is invisible, but it is the major component of air which is taken into consideration which is discussing the weather of any place. Here, think about it. Student, here, think about it. During winter, when you exhale on the glass of your mirror, during winter, you observe it. During winter, when you exhale on the glass of your mirror, what happens? If you try to do this in summer, Why doesn't this happen during winter season? You inhale on the glass if you are spectacle. What happens if you try do this summer? Can you try in this summer, winter? Why doesn't this happen? Next point is our evaporation. What is mean by evaporation? Evaporation is the process of converting water into steam of water vapor. Evaporation is the process converting water into vapor. Converting water into vapor or water vapor because of the sun's heat. The process of evaporation is the process of converting water into vapor or water vapor because of the sun's heat. The water on the earth gets converted. The water of the earth gets converted into water vapor. The process of evaporation is dependent on the dryness, temperature and speed of the wind. Here students, what is mean by evaporation? Evaporation is the process converting water into water or water vapor. Evaporation is the process of converting water into water or vapor or steam. Because of the sun's heat, the water on the earth gets converted into water vapor. Did you understand, student, what is meant by evaporation? Evaporation is the process converting water into steam or water vapor. Evaporation is the process converting water into steam or water vapor is called evaporation. If the air is dry and hot, the rate of evaporation increases. If the air is dry and hot, the rate of water evaporation increases. The process of evaporation continues even in dry and cold air. The process of water evaporation continue even in dry and cold air. On the other hand, evaporation occur very slowly in moist air. In moist air, evaporation occurs very slowly. If the velocity and temperature of air is high, then the evaporation occurs rapidly. Velocity and temperature of the air is very high, evaporation occurs rapidly. And evaporation occurs very slowly in moist air. If the wind is blowing slowly and air is cooler, evaporation occurs slowly. Did you understand, student? Wind is blowing slowly and air is cooler. Wind is blowing slowly and air is cooler. Evaporation occurs very slowly. Did you understand what is meant by and when occur the evaporation? Slowly, fastly, in this way. We complete our point, evaporation. Use your brain power. In which season do the clothes dry fast? Write in your notebook. Use your brain power. In which season do the clothes dry fast? In which season? Then second, in which season do the clothes take time to dry? What could be reason? Write the answer of this question in your notebook. Then our next point is humidity in the air. Last point completed the evaporation. Then next point is humidity in the air. The proportion of water vapor in the air is called humidity. The proportion of water vapor in the air is called humidity. The proportion of water vapor in the air is called humidity. The dryness or dampness of the air depends on proportion of water vapor. In the air's dryness and dampness is depend on the proportion of water vapor. Air can hold moisture in specific quantity at specific temperature only. Air can hold in specific quantity at specific temperature only. As air cools down, its moisture holding capacity reduces. This implies that warmer air can hold more moisture than cold air. Here, student, air can hold moisture in specific quantity at specific temperature only. Air can hold moisture in specific quantity at specific temperature only. Air cools down, its moisture holding capacity reduces. This implies that warmer air can hold more moisture than cold air. This implies that warmer air can hold more moisture than cold air. At a certain temperature, the moisture holding capacity of air becomes equal to the proportion of moisture present in it. This condition of the air is called saturation of the air. At the certain temperature, the moisture holding capacity of the air becomes equal to the proportion of moisture present in it. This condition of air is called as saturation of the air. Here complete two points, evaporation and humidity in the air.